we are going to perform addition between these two values, or we are moving the value from one source to the destination. So like that, the mnemonics will be there. So based upon the instructions, will vary. So whenever we are writing an immediate value means, immediate addressing mode means, the instruction is move some register, we'll write and we'll write the immediate value. So what is this 2000 means? The 2000 is the immediate value that we are giving directly reference in the instruction. Immediate value we are giving directly in the instruction. So whenever we are writing move means, this is always destination and this is always source. This is always destination and this is always source. The 2000 value is moved to the AX register. After executing this instruction, if you see the AX contents, it will be having the value as 2000. If you see AX contents, it will be having the value as 2000. Okay. So we can move a 16-bit value and we can move a 8-bit value. Both are possible. Okay, so example of our 8-bit move is move AL comma some 02. So that is the value 02 is moved into the register AL. Now after executing this instruction, if you see the value AL, then it will be having the value of 02. Okay, so previously whatever the value that is there in the AL, will be erased and the new value will be kept in that memory location, in that register value. So for example, before this instruction, AL is having the value as 03. After this move instruction, this 02 is moved to AL, means this value previously it was 03. Now it will be overwritten and the value will become as 02. Okay. So that is immediate addressing mode. One more important point in the immediate addressing mode, we can treat it as a node. So where always destination should be a register or a memory location. We cannot have an immediate value. So for example, we cannot write the instruction like this. Okay. So the destination side should be a memory location or a register where it can store the value. Since this is not a memory location or not a register, if you are giving like this means, it is like giving to A, like this. Okay. So the value we are not, whatever the contents of A register, that we are not moving to any memory location or this one. So the whatever the value that is there in this A will be lost. Okay. So this is error, purely error, it will show as error. Since the destination is not a memory location or a register value. Okay. And this is also not allowed in 8086. For example, 2000 comma 3000. Both sides, this is immediate value and this is address value. This instruction is not at all allowed in the 8086. Okay. So next one is, now what we will try to do is, we will place this data. Now what I have done is, I have taken a value. This value I have given directly as a reference in the instruction. Now what I will do is, next addressing mode, I will place this value in a register. So in 8086 we are having a different register. I will place this value in a register and I will give this as a reference in the instruction. So that addressing mode is called as register addressing mode. So first I have directly taken the value or the constant data or the immediate value. That value I have given as a reference. Now what I am doing is, I am placing that value and I am placing that value in a register. That register value is given as a reference in the instruction. The example is, in 8086 we are having different registers, are there AX, BX, CX and DX, different registers, different 16 bit registers are there, and we are having different 8 bit registers are there, AL, so AH and AL, BH and BL, CH and CL, and DH and DL. So these are the different 8 bit registers are there, where we can use these 8 bit registers or we can use these 16 bit registers for storing the value. We can use these 8-bit registers or we can use these 16-bit register for storing the value. X indicates 16-bit register, H indicates higher byte, L indicates lower byte. So if we 16-bit data is there, means we can make it is of two parts, 8-bit, 8-bit. So this will become higher byte and this will become lower byte. So like that, DX if we are taking means higher byte and the lower byte. Higher 8-bits, lower 8-bits. Combined it will become a 16-bit data. It will become a 16-bit data. So for example, if I am writing the value 2000 bits, 20 is higher byte value and 00 is the lower byte value. 20 is the higher byte value, 00 is the lower byte value. So this is 8-bit and this is 8-bit. So now how do we write the instruction? How do we write the instruction with the help of register addressing mode bits? How to write the instruction with the help of register addressing mode bits? So the instruction is move AX comma BX, move AX comma BX. So what does this mean is, say for example, BX is having a value, a 20-bit, a 16-bit register, 2000, and AX is having previous value as 3000. 3000 means, whenever we are writing move BX comma AX means, the contents that are present in the BX, the contents that are present in the BX are moved to the AX register. So what will happen now? Now if you see, after executing this instruction, AX will be having the value as 2000 and BX also will be having the value as 2000. So that is the meaning. AX will be having the value of 2000 and BX will be having the value of 2000. So the contents, previous contents of AX will be erased and the new value will be updated in the system. Same value we can send to any number of registers. In 8086 or anything. So move DX comma BX. So what does this mean? So it is, if you take in MS Word, it is always Ctrl C, it is not Ctrl X. Okay, only a copy of this value is moved to the registers. Only a copy of this value will be moved to the registers. The value will be retained in this register only. So the same copy we can send to multiple persons. We can send it to multiple registers. So that is register addressing mode. The same copy value, only a copy of the value will be moved. So after executing this instruction, BX will be having the same value and CX will be having the same value. Okay. So after this instruction, if you write like this means, again like the new value that is present in the BX will be, or AX will be updated. Whatever the value that is present in the AX, for example AX is having different value, again the value will be updated. Okay. So similarly, 8-bit register, we can use the 16-bit register also. So move AL comma BL, So the value that is present in the BL is moved to the AL. So the BL value, whatever it is there, so same value will be copied to the, AL register. So after observing, after executing this instruction, the value, whatever the value that is there, the same value will be there in the AL. So that is this one. And one more important point here is, note in the instruction is, always the source and the destination should match. See, for example, we cannot write an instruction like this. So, why we cannot write an instruction? Means, this is a 16-bit value and this is an 8-bit value. This is 16-bit value and this is 8-bit value. See, for example, this is an 8-bit value, this is an 8-bit value. So I'm trying to give two values at a time. The destination person is having only one hand. Okay, if you give like this means, if you give like this means, only one data can be taken at a time. So like that, so always source and destination register value should be same. Register value should be same. So if we are giving one hand means, the other hand also should be in the same position. Always source and destination register should match. So we cannot give this also is possible, but it will show the error. So at the one hand he is giving a 8-bit value, at the receiver he is having two hands. Okay, only one value will be taken, other hand will be vacant. So we cannot write the instruction like this. So always, whenever we are writing any instruction in 8086, the register size should match. If you are writing 16-bit register means, here also we should write 16-bit register. If you are writing 8-bit register means, source and destination should be always 8-bit register only. We should not give two different registers. It will show this as error, this as error, and this as error. Okay, it will show the, it has a syntax error. It has a syntax error where the syntax is not at all. The architecture, whatever the architecture that is defined, so in that syntax it is not allowed. So that is the register addressing mode. Register addressing mode. Now that we have placed the value, first instruction in immediate addressing mode, we have given this as a reference in the instruction. Now what we have placed in the second addressing mode, we have placed this value in a register. Now what we can do is, I'll place this value in a memory location, and that memory location is given as a reference in the instruction. We can keep. So that is a direct addressing mode. So in the direct addressing mode, the memory value is given. So we can take the value from the memory and we can give the value to the memory. How do we differentiate immediate value with the address means? So already we said immediate value is represented by a constant value. Whenever we need to represent a memory location, it should be kept in terms of a square bracket. If you write the same value in a square bracket, it means it is a memory location, not an immediate value. See, for example, both the instructions are correct only. So by using this instruction, if I am writing move AX, 2000 means, so what does it mean is, after executing this value, AX will be having the value of 2000. Whenever we are executing this instruction move AX, 2000 square bracket 2000 means, the contents that are present in this memory location, the processor will treat this as an address. So the address, the contents of this address will be moved to the AX. Contents of this address means, for example, this is a memory location where the address of that memory location is 2000 and the address of the next memory location is 2001. Okay, in 8086, all are byte addressed memory. That is, byte addressed memory means, in a memory location, we can store only 8 bit of data. We cannot store 16 bit of data. So for example, if I am having 16 bit of data, I need two memory locations for storing the data. If I am having 32 bit of data, I need four memory locations for storing the data. So why? Because in one memory slot, I can store only 8-bit data. So 0000001 like that. I can store only 8-bit data. So what does this instruction means? If I am writing move AX comma 2000 means now AX will be having the value as directly 2000. If I write move AX comma 2000 means contents of this 2000 means the processor will come to this 2000